Hello everybody and welcome back to another part of Roblox game review. This part we'll be reviewing Murder Mystery 2, which for some reason still has a Christmas icon, even though it's not Christmas anymore. I've made a vote about what part 2 for game review should be, and Murder Mystery 2 won. So let's get into the gameplay. Once we are in, we are already greeted with a loading screen. Luckily we can skip it. The lobby is pretty nice. Once you're in a round, you get to see a pretty nice GUI that chooses your role. Once I'm locked in first person, I can't click this menu away. It's also not Christmas anymore. So basically everyone here is possibly the murderer. So we can't trust anyone. Stop chasing me. Wait, you can push these boxes. Let's push it against the ladder so nobody can get up. Are these boxes made out of feathers? Oh look, a secret room. So basically the murderer didn't do anything, which means we were just waiting. So now the round has ended. I just noticed, the tree is invisible, you can only see the decoration. Looks like I'm innocent again. Also, looks like this game doesn't have some sort of script that detects if you're a man or a woman. I just heard a stab. The murderer is active. There's the sheriff. Oh no, there's the murderer. I have to run. Let's tell this sheriff who the murderer is. There she is again. Let's run. That was a nice shot. I also just noticed the floor is invisible. Oh. We have to be sneaky. Time is running out. Where is the last one? Looks like I lost. Let's play one more round. It's the same map, however now I'm innocent. The sheriff is over there. The murderer went straight for the sheriff, and is now camping the gun. A. Stop. Seems like I lost again. So the game had some pretty intense moments. However, you have to wait a lot. I was pretty lucky in the footage I showed, but normally you have to wait something like 4 minutes in that lobby to get in a round. The lobby doesn't have any fun activities, which makes it pretty boring. The gameplay is alright. As you saw from the footage as well, you saw the game has pretty good building, except for how some parts are invisible. The building is good. Now let's see the scripting. It has a voting script and rounds. A shop script. It disguises you when you're in a round, however it doesn't detect your gender. This girl is called Mike. And it shows this GUI after a round. Apart from the GUI scripts, they're all pretty common. They're not really unique. The scripting is alright. Now let's see the community. I'll give you an example of the average Murder Misery 2 player. The community is horrible. The game doesn't really have any ambience, except for the gun and knife sounds. The ambience is alright. Now let's see the ratings. Thanks for watching. I hope you enjoyed my video, and I'll see you in the next one.